We're going to do this one real quick because I got a student coming in like 5 minutes. So Fire in the Rain by Agent Orange. Somebody asked me to do this like a week or two ago, and I've just had the craziest 2 weeks. I've had a show pretty much every day for 2 weeks, so I just haven't had any time to do some videos. But here we go. Here's how. I'm going to show you two ways to do this. Here's how Mike does it. Those two parts, okay? What we're gonna do, it's basically just a B chord, the whole song, okay? A B7 actually, and that A note is just descends chromatically from A down to F sharp. That's it. So we're gonna start with the A note on the 7th fret of the 4th string, and then we're gonna also hold this D sharp note on the 4th fret of the 2nd string. So we're gonna pick that A note, open E, and then the 2nd string, then we're gonna go down right there, okay, to our G sharp. Then the G, then. So that's 4-6-4, third string, last note is on the second string. Then we do it again. Okay, so we end on the B note instead of on the D sharp. That's that. Then we just put it all together, we do a bar and we make them chords. We want to make sure we don't hit these two strings right here, 5 and 6. That's it. That's all there is to it. The easier way to do it, but I don't think it sounds as good, is throw a capo on the 4th fret. Then we don't have access to the open E anymore. That's what makes it cool, is the open E ringing against that D sharp note. But if we don't have it, we could just do this. Yeah, it's just kind of like an F chord shape. Makes it really easy, but like I said, doesn't sound anywhere near as cool as the way those notes just wash over each other and combine. So that's it. Enjoy.